me. Oh, oh, I despise. Cause to me is destruction of this life. One these tears to thousands of mother's eyes when their sons go up to fight and lose their lives.
I said war.
Good God, y'all.
What is it good for?
I absolutely
not
get said again.
Yeah, today is December 28th, 2009. You're watching Life on the Outside. The topic this week is going to be war. And this is a Fearless Broadcast. You can find more information at fearlessbroadcasting.info. And Fearless Broadcasting is brought to you by members of 12160.org, where we do resist the New World Order. And we're going to talk about war today. I've got a lot to cover, so I'm going to get right into it. And we're gonna talk a little bit about how the New World Order funds these bankers. They fund both sides of the war, and they benefit from these wars. And we're gonna talk a little bit about what we are faced today. Now, I want to talk about the figures for the current war. Now, as of November 20th, 2009, the Iraq War Facts results and statistics are as 4,366 U.S. soldiers killed, 31,571 seriously wounded. And this is the current Iraq war I'm talking about. Now, the U.S. spending in Iraq has been about $800 billion of U.S. taxpayers' funds spent or approved for spending through mid-2009, including $76 billion requested by President Obama and approved by Congress. Now, the 2009 monthly spending in Iraq is $7.3 billion as of October 2009. Now, the 2008 figures of monthly spending was $12 billion a month. Now, U.S. spending per second. Now, this is according to Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid on May 5th, 2008, is $5,000 a second. Now, the cost of deploying just one U.S. soldier for 1 year in Iraq is $390,000. That's Congressional Research Service figures. lost and accounted for in Iraq is $9 billion of U.S. taxpayers' money and $549.7 million in spare parts shipped in 2004 to U.S. contractors. Also, per ABC News, 190,000 guns, including 110,000 AK-47 rifles. Now, this is lost and unaccounted for. You understand what I'm saying? All these guns, all these billions of dollars. Also missing is $1 billion in tractor sales, tank recovery vehicles, machine guns, rocket-propelled grenades, and other equipment and services provided to Iraqi security forces. So nobody really knows what happens to all this stuff, all this material, all these weapons, this money. I mean, that benefits no contractors and everything else. How mismanaged and wasted in Iraq is $10 billion. And this was as of February 2007. So we haven't even got the new numbers in for a couple years now, for a few years now. Now, Halliburton overcharges classified by the Pentagon as unreasonable and unsupported is $1.4 billion. The amount paid to KBR, a former Halliburton division, and that's Kellogg, Brown, and Root, to supply U.S. military in Iraq with fuel, food, housing, and other items is $20 billion. Portions of the $20 billion paid to KBR is that the Pentagon auditors deem questionable or supportable is $3.2 billion of that $20 billion. Number of major U.S. bases in Iraq, 75 now. So the project for a new American century is getting their way by building permanent military bases now in the Middle East. Troops in Iraq, the total is 124,000 U.S. troops as of September of 2009. U.S. troops wounded, 35,571. 20% of which is serious brain and spinal injuries. U.S. troops with serious mental problems. 30% of U.S. troops develop serious mental health problems within 3 to 4 months of returning home. And Time reported that Army counseling fights soldiers' post-traumatic stress disorder and rising suicides. So we're seeing rising suicides, we're seeing homicides from returning troops because of mental health issues. Now, private contractors in Iraq working with the support of the U.S. Army troops, more than 180,000. Now, we're going to get into these private contractors in a little bit. Journalists killed, 140,093 by murder, 47 by acts of war. Journalists killed by U.S. forces, 14. Iraqi police and soldiers killed, 9,315. And the official numbers for Iraqi civilians killed is 50,000 to 100,000. But as we know, these figures are probably very much higher. Now, we've seen war throughout the history of the United States, and we have been in several wars. The American Revolution from 1775 to 1783 had 4,435 deaths and 6,188 wounded. The War of 1812, from 1812 to 1815, had 2,260 dead, 4,505 wounded. The Indian Wars, from 1817 to 1898, had 1,000 deaths, and it's not known how many is wounded. The Mexican War, from 1846 to 1848, had 1,733 deaths, 4,152 wounded. And then they have other statistics here of other dead, where maybe you didn't die on the battlefield or there was other circumstances. That number is pretty high, 11,550. Now, the Civil War, the Union forces only, from 1861 to 65, had 140,414 deaths, 281,881 wounded, and 224,097 other deaths. Now, with the Confederates, during the same time frame, 74,524 deaths, unknown how many wounded, and 59,297 other deaths. Now, we've got the Spanish-American War from 1898 to 1902, had 2,061 deaths, 1,662 wounded. and 204,002 unknown deaths. World War I from 1917 to 1918 had 53,402 deaths, 204,002 wounded, and 63,114 other deaths.